Hey guys, in this video we are going to see a very interesting topic, renin-angiotensin system or renin-angiotensin-aldosterone system. It's the same thing. So let's start. Renin-angiotensin system is one of the mechanisms by which body regulates blood pressure and blood volume. Whenever there is fall in blood pressure or fall in blood volume, renin-angiotensin system gets activated and brings pressure and volume back to normal. There are only three things to understand in renin-angiotensin system. First is how body detects fall in blood pressure or volume. Second is cascade of events from renin release to synthesis of angiotensin II. And third is various effects of angiotensin II which ultimately bring blood pressure and volume back to normal. Let's first see how body detects fall in blood pressure and volume. There are three sites for this: baroreceptors at carotid sinus and aortic arch, and macula densa cells and juxtaglomerular cells of juxtaglomerular apparatus in kidney. First, baroreceptors. They are sensitive to stretch on the vessel wall. When there is fall in blood pressure, there will be less stretch on the vessel wall. Baroreceptors detect this fall and via cranial nerve 9 and 10 send this information to medullary control centers in brain. So now these centers increase sympathetic outflow to juxtaglomerular cells in kidney. These nerve endings release noradrenaline, which acts on beta-1 receptors on juxtaglomerular cells, which causes release of renin. So that's the first detector. The second detector is macula densa cells. These cells are sensitive to sodium concentration in the lumen. When there is fall in blood volume or pressure, there will be fall in GFR. This results in decrease in sodium concentration at macula densa. Macula densa cells detect this fall and release nitric oxide and some prostaglandins. They act on juxtaglomerular cells and cause renin release. The third detector is juxtaglomerular cells themselves. These cells also have stretch receptors. When there is fall in blood pressure or volume, there will be reduced stretch on the vessel wall. Juxtaglomerular cells detect this fall and release renin. So after all this detection thing, we have renin in the circulation. Now let's see the cascade of events that result in synthesis of angiotensin II. This part is the simplest one. The liver is releasing a protein, angiotensinogen, all the time in the blood circulation. Renin cleaves 10 amino acid peptide angiotensin I from it. Angiotensin I is then acted upon by another enzyme called angiotensin converting enzyme. This enzyme is present on luminal surface of vascular endothelium. It is present throughout the body, but it is more abundant in lungs. Talking about its action, it removes two more amino acids from angiotensin I and produces angiotensin II. So now we have angiotensin II. Now let's see various effects of angiotensin II and how it brings blood pressure and volume back to normal. The first effect, as evident by the name itself, is vasoconstriction. Angiotensin II mainly causes constriction of arterioles. This results in increased total peripheral resistance, which in turn increases blood pressure. It also causes constriction of veins to some extent. This increases venous return, which increases cardiac output and thereby increases blood pressure. Second effect is sodium retention and thereby retention of water by kidney. Angiotensin does this by two ways: by increasing release of aldosterone, as well as by its direct action. First, let's see aldosterone, as it is the major here. Angiotensin II acts on glomerulosa cells of the adrenal cortex and stimulates release of aldosterone. The aldosterone acts on collecting duct, where we have principal cells. Here, sodium is being reabsorbed by epithelial sodium channels at the apical membrane and sodium-potassium ATPase pump on the basolateral membrane. Aldosterone increases expression of genes for sodium channels and sodium-potassium ATPase pump. Thus, with more of these transport proteins, more sodium is reabsorbed. Now let's see the direct effects of angiotensin II. First, it acts on proximal tubule. Here, various transporters are involved in sodium reabsorption, and one of them is sodium-hydrogen exchanger. Angiotensin II increases activity of this exchanger, which contributes in increasing sodium reabsorption. Second direct effect of angiotensin II is hemodynamic and requires understanding of Starling forces at peritubular capillary. In this video, we are going to keep the discussion to the point, but you can see detailed explanation of Starling forces in video of tubular processing. Coming back to the effect of angiotensin II, it constricts efferent arteriole. This brings about two changes in hemodynamics of peritubular capillary. The first is, it decreases hydrostatic pressure in peritubular capillaries. Second, it increases filtration fraction, so collar osmotic pressure in the peritubular capillary increases. Both of these changes cause increase in uptake of reabsorbate from interstitium into the capillary. This in turn increases reabsorption of sodium and water from tubule. So these are the ways by which angiotensin II causes sodium retention. Now you might be already knowing that in body, water follows sodium. So sodium retention in turn causes water retention, which brings blood volume and pressure back to normal. Among other effects are its effects on hypothalamus, where it stimulates ADH release, and thirst. Both of these contribute in increasing body water. So these were the effects of angiotensin II. Half-life of angiotensin II is about 2 minutes. And finally, our very dear friend is degraded by multiple enzymes collectively called angiotensinases. So this was renin-angiotensin system. Now let's have a summary. Renin-angiotensin system is involved in regulation of blood volume and blood pressure. The fall in blood volume or pressure are detected at three sites. First is baroreceptors. On sensing the fall, they send signals to the medullary centers in the brain, which in turn send signal to juxtaglomerular cells to increase renin release. Second thing is, fall in blood volume or pressure decreases glomerular filtration rate. This decreases sodium concentration at macula densa. Macula densa senses this fall and signals juxtaglomerular cells to release renin. Finally, juxtaglomerular cells themselves can also detect fall in pressure by their inbuilt stretch receptors. Coming to the synthesis of angiotensin II. The liver is releasing a protein, angiotensinogen, all the time in the blood circulation. Renin cleaves off angiotensin 1 from it. Then angiotensin converting enzyme removes 2 more amino acids from it and produces angiotensin 2. Now effects of angiotensin 2. First, vasoconstriction. It causes arteriolar constriction, which increases total peripheral resistance, which increases blood pressure. It also causes venoconstriction, although to a lesser extent. This increases venous return, which increases cardiac output, which contributes in increasing blood pressure. Now effects on sodium retention. Angiotensin II increases aldosterone release. Aldosterone induces synthesis of epithelial sodium channels and sodium potassium ATPase pump, which are involved in sodium reabsorption at principal cells. This increases sodium reabsorption. Angiotensin II also directly stimulates activity of sodium hydrogen exchanger at proximal tubule, which increases sodium reabsorption. Now that hemodynamic effect. Angiotensin II constricts efferent arteriole. It decreases hydrostatic pressure in peritubular capillaries. It also increases filtration fraction, which increases collar osmotic pressure in peritubular capillary. Both of these hemodynamic changes increase uptake of reabsorbate from interstitium, which in turn increases overall reabsorption, including that of sodium and water. Sodium retention causes water retention, which brings blood volume and pressure back to normal. Among other effects are its effects on hypothalamus, where it stimulates ADH release, and thirst. Both of these contribute in increasing body water. So this was renin-angiotensin system. That's it for this video. If you found this video helpful, please share it with your friends. And don't forget to subscribe, because lots more to come. Thank you for watching. See you in next video.